As I wrote this book, I had to really come to terms with why I spent 10 years of my life trying to understand moral behavior. One of the reasons was that I had shown prior to doing this work that interpersonal trust was among the strongest predictors of whether countries would be rich or poor. So high trust countries have more social interactions, more social interactions lead to more economic interactions. Some of those economic interactions create wealth, and you have this sustaining process. So the dishonest answer from why I did this work was, it's important to understand poverty, and you know that's true. But the real honest answer was that when I grew up, I had a very unusual mother. She was a former Catholic nun. You think you had an unusual upbringing, you have to talk to me. Wasn't that a Freudian slip? My mother quit being a nun in the 1950s because she didn't think her convent was strict enough. So instead she decided to have children and be strict with us. So when I was a child at home, mom was the ultimate authority, right? Mom saw everything in black and white. There was no disagreement that wouldn't come down to, God tells you, you must do it this way. Okay, mom, I'll clean my room better. I'm sorry, I don't want to go to hell. But as I got older, I started rejecting that black and white view. I thought, look, if God exists, God must live in the gray, right? If God is good for anything, he must tell us where to live in the gray. And I just couldn't believe this kind of black and white behavior was all there was in the world. And so I really pushed back. I stopped going to mass. I kind of said, you know, I need to make my own religion. I just can't live with this black and white certainty. I don't think the world's so certain. So as a result, in these experiments, I avoided asking almost any question you could think of regarding religion. We said, do you pray? Do you go to church? That didn't really matter for these experiments. So then I said, I call this the weenie alert. Do you have this phrase in Portuguese? The weenie alert goes off. Don't be afraid of doing something that's scary. Okay, so we started doing experiments where we had people come in who are religious and pray in a lab and measure their blood and measure the behavior. We went into churches and took blood before and after church services, with permission, of course. We looked at other aspects of rituals. Many ancient religious rituals involved movement, like dance. So we went to a folk dance and took blood before and after. And we found that in a majority of these settings, the people involved in the ritual would release oxytocin, and when they did, they would feel closer to their community. We didn't find that oxytocin made people feel closer to God or some ultimate reality. So whatever motivates that feeling in religious believers doesn't seem to be oxytocin.